You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and they will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. I welcome you all as we gather here this morning to say farewell to Frankie. I know people have come from a long distance, and many people have come from Longford here today. And many people are joining us over the webcam too, as we celebrate this Mass. Along with myself and Father Michael, we gather here to pray for Frankie and to accompany him on his final journey to God. We ask the Lord to place him with all those who have gone before us. Especially we think of his parents, Frank and Josephine, his sister Monica, and his brothers Seamus and Tony, who passed away so recently too, and also with his granddaughter Hannah Jane. We gather also to pray for ourselves, asking God to console us at this time of loss. And especially today we pray for those who are closest to Frankie and who loved him so dearly. Bridie, his wife, his children Loretto, Annette, Ciarán, Fergal, Johannah and Carol-Ann, and his 12 grandchildren and his great-grandchildren, his son-in-law and daughter-in-law, his brothers John, Michael, Oliver and Paschal, his sisters Annie and Mary, his nephews, nieces, relatives and many, many friends. We pray for all who are close to him, and we ask God to bring you comfort today through the prayers and the readings that we'll hear in our Mass. We have a faith in the promises of God that we will meet again in God's kingdom and we shall see Frankie again. Frankie was a very special person to us all, and as we gather here today, you might like to think of a moment that was particularly special for you, a moment that you shared with Frankie, an occasion of joy, some advice, some celebration that maybe you attended. And we bring all our memories before the Lord. We're going to bring to the altar now as well some symbols of the interest that Frankie had in life. And Richard is going to tell us what those symbols are, and Joanna will tell us a little bit about Frankie. So please be seated now.
Craig brings forward drumsticks and a photo of Frankie and the Black Dots. Music was a fundamental part of Frankie's life from an early age. He went on to play drums and sing with Frankie and the Black Dots for more than a decade. And after that, he never missed an opportunity to perform a few songs at family gatherings, charity events, or functions. Connor brings up a crucifix representing Frankie's unwavering faith and the strong link to St. Mel's Cathedral in Longford. The crucifix, which hung on Frankie's bedroom wall, is made from wood that was taken from the ruins of St. Mel's after it was destroyed by fire in 2009. Frankie was baptised, confirmed and married in St. Mel's, as were many generations of his family, and it held a very special place in his heart throughout his life. Adam brings forward a cushion with a photo of Bridie and Frankie. The cushion was given to Frankie by Fergal and Deirdre to comfort him after he'd moved to a nursing home and was missing Bridie. Killian brings forward a drawing he made for his granddad. Killian regularly sent home drawings to brighten up his granddad's day. All his pictures hung on the wall in Brookside and in the nursing home and brought Frankie great joy. Sean brings up two football jerseys, one for Longford Town and the other for Laytown East Ham United. Football was a huge part of Frankie's life, having played for and managed Longford Town, managed Laytown East Ham and the Altar Service football team. Match of the day was a weekly ritual, never to be disturbed. Thank you. James brings up a photo of the family. Family life was very important to Frankie. He loved Bridie and his six children, and everything he did was for them. Curtis brings up a lottery ticket. Frankie loved going down to do his weekly lottery, which became an even bigger highlight of the week after he became ill. When asked by the girls in Tesco why he continued to do the lotto, Frankie said he didn't want the money for himself, he wanted it for his family and to give away to charity, and he told them he'd clear their mortgages too.
I suppose I have to start with an apology to Father Dennis, because when we spoke yesterday, I said I'll only speak for 2 or 3 minutes, and then I started writing, and it's a lot longer than 2 or 3 minutes, and I should have known it would be. Most people will know our dad as Frankie, the musician and singer, the footballer, and the man who worked for AIF and down in the credit union as well. To us, he was daddy, loving, witty, supportive, inclusive, welcoming, quite black and white, a bit stubborn, and so unbelievably generous. I'd even say that Dad was different things to each of his children. He saw us all as individuals, and we could all stand up here today and say different things about our relationship with him. It's hard to talk about Dad without talking about Mum, because they were a team, completely inseparable and a very dynamic duo. For over 58 years of marriage, they supported one another and were devoted to their children and wider family. But today is about Dad as he takes his final journey from this church, a church that meant so much to him. As soon as he arrived in Bettystown, back in 1977 on a visit, he met Father Joe Gleeson and became involved with the church right up until he became ill in 2014. Over the years, he sang here and in Mornington Church. He took part in novenas, holy hours, and other holy days and festivals. It's very fitting that today we have John Moore playing at Dad's funeral, having performed in this church with John so many times. John was an incredible friend to Dad, who regularly visited him in hospital and at home to help him with his speech, and had a good sing-song together, and Dad was only too delighted to join in. John is joined today by one of Dad's favourite singers, Des Willoughby of the Celtic Brothers. I know Dad would be delighted they're here to sing some of his favourite hymns, and it really is the perfect send-off. We have a saying in our family, which was never fear because Daddy's here. He was a chief problem solver, so no matter what happened, he had a solution, and it didn't matter what had to be done, he'd do it. His generosity knew no bounds, and he helped all six of us start out in life, knowing we had him and Mam behind us every step of the way. We grew up on an appetite of music and sport, mostly football, and faith. Dad listened to the Beatles, Glen Campbell, Johnny Cash, Charlie Pride, and a host of Irish country stars. There was always music on, sometimes in more than one room at a time, and the albums of these artists became the soundtrack to our childhood. And he used music to great effect to get us out of bed on a Sunday morning for Mass. After 9 a.m, the volume would steadily increase until we got the message. Looking back, I don't think I would have been too happy to be the neighbours of our family. We had a drum kit, keyboard, accordion, guitars, and an amp with a microphone, often in use at the same time. It's safe to say our house was not a quiet one. In fact, Dad never got used to the house being quiet. He loved the hubbub of people coming and going. Certainly my friends gathered around the kitchen table on a winter's evening, cradling hot cups of tea and devouring our supply of biscuits. Fergal and his friends would be practicing for a gig, and Ciarán would be perfecting Bagatelle's Summer in Dublin. As a family, we loved tuning in to Top of the Pops on a Thursday night. Dad always gave a running commentary as he tried to work out if a particular person was male or female, or whether a singer was wearing a long T-shirt or a short skirt. He was totally bemused by acid house music, and Annette remembers him being specifically horrified by the Blockhead song, Hit Me With Your Rhythm Stick. What sort of lyrics are they, he'd say. That's not a song at all. We've so many special memories from our childhood, far too many to go through today, but a few stand out. Holidays to Galway, Sunday drives to Skerries and up to Dublin Airport to watch the planes taking off and land. Heading down to Longford to spend time with our extended family while Mum and Dad went to Lourdes. Picnics on the beach here in Bettystown and Laytown. Day visits to Mosney, long drives through Wicklow. And everyone's favourite 1980s holiday memory, having soggy picnic in the rain while you did your best to hold up the umbrella. I think that's something that happened to many of us. We all have fantastic memories of going up to Seafield to watch Laytown East Ham United. The 1980s really was a golden time for the club. But what I remember the most about Dad during that era was his consideration to visiting teams and his attention to detail. The pitch had to be immaculate, and he always made sure that there was hot tea for both teams at the end of the game. He wanted the away team to have a positive experience and to show fair play and respect. I can still remember the smell of the kit bag that I used to lug around, and Ciarán and Fergal too. To this day, the smell of Ralgex and bandages brings me right back to the hut in the Seafield. Dad was always very smartly dressed, even on match days. There was a joke amongst the lads in Laytown that Dad was the only ref and manager who would turn up to a game in a three-piece suit and a pair of wellies. When Dad first started working in Drogheda in 1977, he quickly realised Drogheda had its own accent and there were sayings that he just didn't understand. He would stand outside Dunstores and West Street, an earwig on conversations as the people chatted outside. He soon learned that when someone said that the child was up grinning all night, they meant the child was crying, not laughing. There was murders at inn last night meant there was trouble, and I'll burst you meant you'll get a clatter. He grew to love Drogheda's buzzy streets and vibrant restaurants. It was a brilliant shopping town, and he shopped with many of the same people for years, Paddy Dwyer's, Dowd's, and not forgetting Bolton Square Market, where he went every single Saturday. He immediately fell in love with the sleepy seaside village of Bettystown when he first drove through it. He saw a woman and thought he'd ask her if she knew if there was any houses for sale. That woman was the late Tess Towle, and she directed Dad up the road to a new housing estate that was being built. That estate was Brookside, and after a quick drive around, he knew this was the place he wanted to live. And it was the most wonderful place to grow up. We were truly blessed with great neighbours and friends. Dad had a great sense of humour, and he knew his audience, so he carefully picked the stories and jokes to share. He loved English comedy, the two Ronnies, especially the Four Candles sketch, Only Fools and Horses and Fawlty Towers. He would cry with laughter while watching them. He also enjoyed a bit of banter with our late friend John Carlin. Their banter was legendary and would leave us all in tears of laughter. I hope today they've picked up where they've left off. He had killer one-liners and quips, always quick to humour. He used to go in and out of the same shop buying his lottery ticket in Drogheda, and after a few weeks, the woman behind the counter asked, is Fergal Flaherty your son? And Dad looked up from under his cap and said, well, he claims to be, and just walked out. One night, Fergal was doing a gig, and my dad and cousin Tommy were there, and there were issues with the sound. They went down to the desk to chat to the sound engineer to let him know things needed to be tweaked a bit. Of course, the engineer took great offence about being told how to do his job. He said, I'm the engineer, not you. And Daddy replied, well, you must be an engineer for Éireann Road Éireann because you're no sound engineer. Dad took great interest in people of all ages. He wanted people to excel in life and be happy. He was always giving financial advice, even when he was off duty. He was passionate about supporting young people to get on their feet, as he remembered only too well how difficult it was growing up in Ireland during an era when times were very hard for most people. He never forgot those hardships, and that's why he got so involved with St. Vincent de Paul. He wanted to do his bit to ensure families, especially children, didn't go without. He never forgot his hometown of Longford. He continued to follow Longford Town FC, and he enjoyed getting all the latest news from his brothers, sisters, and his late family, his late friends, Eileen and Harry Farrell. He loved going to Tenerife to visit Fergal and Deirdre with Mam, to sing a few songs in the hole in the wall. I think it's fair to say he developed a whole new following of his own based on those performances. After Dad got sick in 2014, we had to get to know a different Dad. He could no longer communicate with ease, and losing his ability to have conversations was a devastating blow for him. Nevertheless, he was determined not to let it affect him. Over 8 years, he fought every step of the way to still be able to go out for a short walk, drop into the copper kettle and drawder for a scone and tea, and just to be sitting at the fire at home with Mam. He repeatedly defied medical experts and bounced back so many times from many serious health issues that we gave him the nickname Lazarus. Sorry, Father. He amazed us all with his determination, resilience, strength and courage. He definitely had a renewed zest for life with the arrival of my son Killian and his three great-grandchildren, Elsie, Frankie and Rhea. In fact, all of his grandchildren meant the world to him, and he loved when they visited him. We will forever be grateful for having those extra years with him and to allow him to see all his grandchildren and three of his great-grandchildren. Finally, I just want to say a few thank yous on behalf of the family, to the staff in A&E acute care unit on the sixth floor of Our Lady of Lourdes Hospital, the step-down facility at Louth County Hospital Dundalk. They just showed great compassion and love towards Dad. Thank you to the carers who cared for Dad while he was at home. They used to come two or three times a day to look after him. To the devoted staff at Silverstream Nursing Home in Duleek, who took such great care of Dad in his final months, and they became his friends. To our neighbours and friends who visited Dad over the last 8 years for the chats, the sing-songs, or they just came to sit and be there while he slept. Thank you to those who helped with lifts to hospitals and to the nursing home, who sent cards, emails, made phone calls, who listened, who counselled. All those gestures made a huge difference to Mam and all the family. I know if Dad was here, he would want me to thank my brothers and sisters, Loretto, Annette, Ciarán, Fergal and Carol-Ann, for all that they did over the last 8 years. Each of you gave so much to make things as comfortable as possible for him and to be his voice when he didn't have one. Loretta and Ciarán, thank you in particular for being there on the day-to-day to support Mam and Dad. The final word of thanks goes to my mum. For 7 years, you cared for Dad in the comfort of his own home. I know it broke your heart when he had to go into the home, but after 7 years, his medical needs became too complex to manage. Your love, care, and attention are the reason we had those extra years with him, which we'll all cherish forever. Thank you.
Thanks to Richard and Joanna for sharing all those memories. As I said, we bring all our memories of Frankie now before the Lord as we commend him into God's loving embrace. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Frankie to be inscribed in the book of life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. So now we're going to listen to our readings from the scriptures, and Tommy is going to read the first reading, and then after the psalm is sung, Stephen will read the second.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. I have fought the good fight to the end. As for me, my life is already being poured away in libation, and the time has come for me to depart. I have fought the good fight to the end. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith. All there is to come for me now is the crown of uprightness, which the Lord, the upright judge, will give to me on that day. And not only to me, but to all those who have longed for his appearing. This is the word of the Lord.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin. My hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I will hold your people in my heart.
Second reading. A reading from a letter to St. John. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, escorted by all the angels, then he will take his seat on his throne of glory. All the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate people one from another as the shepherd separates sheep from goats. He will place the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, 'Come, you whom my Father has blessed, take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you made me welcome. Naked and you clothed me, sick and you visited me, in prison and you came to see me.' Then the virtuous will say to him in reply, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and make you welcome, naked and clothe you, sick or in prison and go to see you?' And the king will answer, 'I tell you solemnly, insofar as you did this to one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did it to me.' Next he will say to those on the left hand, 'Go away from me with your curse upon you to the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you never gave me food. I was thirsty, you never gave me anything to drink. I was a stranger and you never made me welcome. Naked and you never clothed me, sick and in prison, and you never visited me.' Then it will be their turn to ask, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, a stranger or naked, sick or in prison, and did not come to your help?' Then he will answer, 'I tell you solemnly, insofar as you neglected to do this to one of the least of these, you neglected to do it to me.' And they will go away to eternal punishment, and the virtuous to eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord.
In the Gospel today, Jesus says, "I was hungry and you gave me to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me to drink. I was a stranger and you made me welcome. I was naked and you clothed me." Jesus points out something that could change the world. And yet it's something that is so simple. For these are things that aren't beyond any of us. And in fact, some of them are the kind of things that parents do all the time. They do it when they look after their children, feeding the hungry, getting them breakfast before school, or when they come in at the end of the day starving and the dinner goes on. Clothing the naked, making sure they have all the essentials. Christ declares that the business of the home is the business of his kingdom. And he says, as long as you did this to one of the least of these, you did it to me. Reflecting on Frankie's life over the past few days, we've been telling and retelling stories of his goodness, of his exceptional kindness, and how he was greatly loved by all. How he was always so generous with his time and with his love. He was well reared in Longford himself. All during his lifetime, he shared the gifts and the talents that were nurtured in his own childhood. And Frankie was born in Longford town in April 1939, the second child to his parents, Frank and Josephine. And over the next 15 years, 8 more brothers and sisters joined the family. From a young age, Frankie showed a great flair for sport and music, and he had a passion for people. From the age of 14, he worked as a delivery boy for Breton's Bakery and Hurricanes, and his favourite part of this job was meeting and talking to customers, many of whom became lifelong friends. He went on to work for CIE and later joined Allied Irish Finance in Longford before being transferred here to Drogheda in 1977. He worked with AIF for more than 25 years, and on his retirement from the bank, he went on to work as a financial advisor with Canada Life for 11 years. As we recalled with the symbols that we brought up at the beginning of Mass, Frankie is probably best known as the singer and drummer with Frankie and the Black Dots, a show band that played in many of the country's biggest and smallest dance halls in the 60s and 70s. He played with Tony and Oliver, his brothers. And when he moved here to Laytown and Bettystown, Frankie didn't waste any time in getting involved in the community in East Meath. As we heard back in the 80s, he was heavily involved in Laytown East Ham United as manager, chairman and treasurer. I don't know if it was a coincidence that the colours of black and red were the same as those of Longford Town. He helped to coach the Altar Servers football team too in the Altar Servers League, leading them on to cup victory on more than one occasion. He brought them as well to play against his native Longford Town. He also accompanied John Andrews and the Servers on their 17 days trip to Rome, climbing the Alps along the way. And I'm told that he nearly got frostbite because he insisted that he was going to climb the Alps in his shorts. As Joanna said, Frankie was very involved in the church here from the earliest of times, working with Father Gleeson right up until a few years ago when he wasn't able to make it anymore. And he would sing here at Mass, both in Laytown and in Mornington, not singing as a soloist really himself, but rather encouraging everybody here present to be singing together. And I think that's something that he always enjoyed, the fact that everyone would join together in singing, something he enjoyed here and at home and in other places. Over the last 40 years, Frankie gave endless hours to charity work, to the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, the Credit Union, MABS, and the Irish Blood Transfusion Service. And he was a lifelong member of the Pioneer Association as well. But above all else, it was family that meant everything to Frankie. He was a devoted husband and father, adored Bridie and all his children. Spending time with them, just being with them. We know that when he walked into a room, he could bring the room to life. He had an absolutely wonderful smile. And as I said, he loved meeting people. The chat would start, then all the stories and the sharing of his love of music. After his stroke, he really enjoyed John coming down to play. And when Fergal was home, of course, that was the icing on the cake. And I know that he would have been delighted to have here today Des and Daniel and John playing and leading the music for us here. Family will have very fond memories, some recounted by Johannah at the beginning of Mass, some more personal that you'll treasure in your hearts. Frankie wanted the best for you and gave his all for you and for everyone. Neighbours, sporting organisations, those he helped out quietly through his charity, giving not only his time but also of his own resources. I know when he used to visit houses with the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, he'd take note of what was there, and if he saw that there was something in particular that a family needed, he'd pay for it out of his own monies and was given quietly with no looking for a reward. Coming to the aid of families in need, living the life marked out in the gospel, he was blessed and we were blessed by his generous heart. Of course, life wasn't always easy. The scriptures tell us that the path to glory is often one where we have to carry a cross, and there were challenges over the years. I was thinking back of the fire that you went through some years ago, and of course his own health issues, suffering a stroke 8 years ago. And although I'm sure at times he must have been frustrated, he always kept his spirits up. I was so grateful to Bridie and all his family and neighbours who looked after him so well and brought him to all his appointments and kept him company all the time. But why wouldn't they? He'd have done the same himself. St. Paul issues the challenge in the reading today. There is a race to be run. There is a prize to receive. We keep our focus on heaven and the glory that awaits us. Living the kind of virtues that Jesus promotes in the gospel today marks the course and paves the way to God's kingdom. It is in the practice of true love that we leave childhood ways behind and begin to see things more clearly. Every time that Frankie was good to another, kind to another, generous to another, said a kind word to another, that paved the way for God's kingdom on earth. Frankie in his own way promoted the kingdom of heaven here, in his daily interactions and in his acts of kindness. And if he promoted the kingdom of heaven here, he will certainly be no stranger to the kingdom of heaven there. We pray that Frankie will hear the words spoken by Christ today. Come you, blessed of my Father, take the inheritance prepared for you. May God's faithfulness and love open to him the same kingdom in heaven, where Frankie will see God face to face. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. I ask you all to stand now as we have our prayers of the faithful, and those who are doing the prayers can come forward now. And let us pray with confidence and trust in the power of God who raised Jesus Christ from the dead and whose promise is that one day we shall be like him.
We pray for Uncle Frankie. May God receive him kindly with generosity and forgiveness and the rewards of his fate. May he continue to inspire us, to intercede for us and be there for us, to welcome us into eternal life. Lord, hear us.
For Grandad, that God will reward him with peace and joy for the good he did during his life and for the love and dedication he showed his family, friends and community. Lord, hear us.
For all the neighbours and friends who have been such a support to his family over the last 8 years, We pray the Lord will bring us together again at happier times and lead us to the joys of his kingdom, where we will be united with Frankie once more. Lord, hear us.
We pray for all the deceased members of the Flaherty and G families, our grandparents, Aunts Monica, Patricia and Catherine, Uncles Mick, Seamus and Tony. Lord, hear us.
For Uncle Frankie, who for so long had been under the limitations and pain of sickness, that he may now have the freedom and joy of the kingdom. Bless all those who cared for Uncle Frankie, especially those who cared for him at home, and the team at Silverstream Nursing Home in Duleek for their outstanding care and love. Lord, hear us.
For those who are suffering or dying in our parish, that the Lord Jesus, the Good Shepherd, may bring them unending consolation and joy in heaven. We also pray for those who are feeling lonely and isolated, that they find comfort and support in their community. Lord, hear us.
Lord God, whose days are without end and whose mercies are beyond counting, keep us mindful that life is short and the hour of death unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days in the ways of holiness and justice, that we may serve you in union with the whole Church, sure in faith, strong in hope, perfect in love. And when our earthly journey is ended, lead us rejoicing into your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Please be seated now as our gifts of bread and wine are brought to the altar.
A Christ on shield, a Christ on four, in nail and day, God doctor shin, a Christ on wheel, a Christ on tease, Ilium today, Gogaster Shin. O Ashka Ish, Iso Ishka Bas, Da of a Christ, and now. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Frankie, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful Judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever.
May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Tom our Bishop and all the clergy.
Remember your servant, Frankie, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, the blessed apostles, and all saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours for ever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. We offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Though it be
we. Go mare isa, go John ar gris. Ave Maria, ma grave. Is the stomach water? Is Maher Jay? Ave Maria, Magrave. Is the Samawahar? Is Maher Jay? Aware of her, the land, the grass, go road to Thievlam, Erur Mawash, Ave Maria. Magrave is the Samawahar, is Maher Jay. Ave Maria, Magrave. Is the Samawahar, is Maher Jay. I'm on a journey, I'm going home. No more to wander, no more to roam. My dearest mother awaits me there. Ave Maria, this is my prayer. My dearest mother awaits me there. Ave Maria, this is my
Savior God to thee.
thou breathe thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Sorry, before I sing, I just want to say I didn't know that Daniel O'Donnell was going to be here today. And it's been an amazing friend over many years, and Daddy loved his music. And I had picked this song to sing today, not knowing Daniel was here. And it's just ironic that Daniel wrote this song. I have gone from sight, but I am waiting, waiting just beyond the rainbow's end. I'm happy in this place that I have come to, because I'm here with my forever friend. Now all your thoughts of me, let them be joyful, of things we've done and happy times we share. So don't be sad, dear ones, because I've left you. Please laugh and talk about me as if I'm there. Just look up to the sky, I am the sunshine, and the mist that rises on summer's morn. I'm the gentle breeze that cools the autumn evening, when a bird sings in the trees, I am their song. This journey I have made, one day you'll make it. You too will be with my forever friend. Is there once more that we will be together? I'll meet you just beyond the rainbow's end. Is there once more that we will be together? I'll meet you just beyond the rainbow's end. Yes, I'm waiting just beyond the rainbow's end.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Frankie may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. I know Frankie's family are very much appreciative of all those who have come to be with them and share with them in their sorrow today, and also to celebrate Frankie's life, for he certainly was a man who left a lot behind him in terms of his example, in terms of his love and his generosity, things for us to follow. But I'd like to invite anybody who has travelled a distance to join them for some refreshments in the village hotel after the burial right up at the cemetery. You'd be very welcome. The Lord be with you. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Frankie. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Response to the song of farewell is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. In Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Frankie, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Frankie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our brother Frankie forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And in peace now, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Just go.